It really is an art. No matter where you are in the world, you're never far from a coffee shop. That's especially true in Italy, where espresso culture is a way of life. Whether it's the cappuccino in the morning or a quick shot of espresso in the afternoon, it's a daily ritual, and it's catching on across the globe. On this episode of Innovation Hall, I sat down with Siena College history professor Wendy Pojmann, who's done extensive research on espresso culture in Italy and here at home. I wanted to learn what effect espresso culture has here at home in the capital region. So we sat down over what else? Coffee.
Tomato breve pan. I've learned how to take pictures of coffee.
Oh, yeah. It's an art.
So what exactly is espresso culture?
Espresso really accompanies Italians and people who live in Italy throughout their daily lives.
It's really more of a ritual. Italians tend to less emphasize the role of caffeine. Some will say, like, you know, espresso will give me a little extra jolt to keep going throughout the day. But more of it's about the sociability, about friendship, about sharing a moment with someone. And everywhere I went, especially in Naples, they would say, caffè un rito, coffee is a ritual.
What do you talk about over coffee?
Italians are funny because even while you're having coffee or eating, you're often talking about having coffee and eating. Right, so a lot of times, a lot of conversations actually revolve around that experience.
When you research espresso culture, a lot of it is going out and sitting in the places, right? Like, what does your research consist of?
So a lot of it is participant observation, so it's just a matter of my personal experiences. I did in many of the places then ask for interviews with owners or barista or managers at some of the places I identified as having particular importance during a decade. In Rome, one of the bars that I go to is in Trastevere, which is the medieval neighborhood in Rome, and I used to go there on my way to the archives, and it was kind of a rough and ready kind of neighborhood bar, and you know, so I became curious about their history, and so looked a little bit at, for instance, artists in the neighborhood and why they went there and how that contributed to cinema culture, for instance. Or I went to some that were from the Dolce Vita era. I looked at the history of the machines, of chemistry, of coffee cultivation, looking at the development of the cities themselves, how the espresso bars are part of the urban landscape.
How has espresso culture become globalized?
Well, I think that there's always been a fascination with Italy. Americans love Italy, love traveling to Italy, love the food, love the design. You know, there's a sort of made in Italy phenomenon that I think interests Americans. I think that's a big part of it. And I think, too, maybe like once you've had espresso, you realize how good it is. And you want to keep drinking good coffee?
Yeah. If that's the only reason, and then that satisfies me.
How have we in the capital region embraced espresso culture? I mean, have we embraced it? Is it here?
Somewhat, yes. Of course, where we are sitting today, I was thrilled to discover this place when I first moved to Schenectady several years ago, because walking in here does feel a lot like an Italian pasticceria coffee shop. But there are a number of other coffee shops that have opened in the region in the last several years, and they are serving, again, espresso drinks, but also this kind of third wave coffee with like a Chemex system or these pour over coffees. And some of them, I would say, do encourage a kind of lively environment where people sit and talk and, you know, converse over coffee. Some of them also have some alcoholic beverages, sort of transition from coffee shop to maybe birria, you know, the beer place in the evening. Other places, though, that feel a little bit more like study halls when you go in, right? So, you know, especially a lot of students or, you know, workers who don't have office space or whatever, you know, who sit for hours and drink coffee and get their work done, which is a very different, that's not very common in Italy.
For you, what is the most fascinating thing about espresso culture?
I think because it is a distinctly Italian phenomenon, born in Italy, made Italian, but then
again, sort of retranslated abroad, and now I'm seeing even some of what's happened abroad being brought back into Italy. So just this back and forth of the reach, and you know, and again, my favorite thing about, I think, the espresso culture is the ritual of it, and that's what I would like to see continue to thrive and to be, you know, a part of coffee culture wherever it may be.
Yeah, you can do really fun things with that, like, yeah, coffee shops around Italy.
Yeah, so that's what I've been doing with it.